that later tonight, he might as well advertise it as a handicap match. You got Batista, the number one contender, against Ric Flair, Triple H, and now what? The Sledgehammer 2?
Oh, and the Sledgehammer 2.
I predict it's going to be 3-on-1. We are back live here at North Carolina State University. Jim Ross and Jerry the King Lawler here on Monday Night Raw. And ladies and gentlemen, next Monday night, we're going to be in Atlanta, Georgia. And we just found out, folks, in the Pick Your Poison match, who Batista has chosen for the game to face next week.
There he is.
There he is. Chris Benoit will meet the game 1-on-1 next week in Atlanta.
Boy, Batista is hoping, he's praying that Benoit will do a number on Triple H before WrestleMania.
Hey, Benoit is the man that made Triple H tap at WrestleMania 20 in Madison Square Garden. The game has yet to beat Benoit 1-on-1. Atlanta, get ready. And the ovation for the Nature Boy here in Raleigh, North Carolina, the old Mid-Atlantic territory. It is Ric Flair's country.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Charlotte, North Carolina, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Well, you're right. Flair is the team. Here's how. And we know why. That sledgehammer in the hands of the game, and then driven through into the ribs of Rosie. You know what, I understand that there's another big bed right beside Rosie in that emergency room, and it's just waiting for Batista.
Will someone else be hospitalized tonight?
Folks, Raw SmackDown present WrestleMania, sponsored by Snickers Crunchers. WrestleMania will be live Sunday, April 3rd, from the sold-out Staples Center in Hollywood, and exclusively on pay-per-view. Make it happen, Snickers Cruncher.
There's Nate.
And here comes Batista.
After watching the game,
the fans here in North Carolina State on their feet. The game not taking his eyes off the number one contender for the world's heavyweight title. The 318-pounder known as Batista. Comes down to Evolution. What a magnificent, intimidating physique. A man that has size, 6'5", 318, strength and power and agility. Batista's got it all. And man, I'll tell you what, the game I know is absolutely livid with all this. Seemingly, every day it gains more fan support for Batista.
Yes, you're right, the game's livid. But you heard the game's pep talk to Nate. He reminded Nate that Nate is a 16-time world champion. He is the dirtiest player in the game. He's maybe the greatest there's ever been.
He doesn't have a sledgehammer in the corner.
Well, our general manager made another wise move, unarming the game, who was going to come to the ring with a sledgehammer and the Nature Boy. And there'll be some Flair fans here tonight, no doubt about it. You'll hear some woos. But, well, there's nothing like the ovation that Batista just received. King fans all around us are standing.
Well, I realize that, but did you see the look on Triple H's face? Beside himself.
They're locking up the Batista and the overwhelming power advantage. Good grief, look at that. That's the intensity. The intensity of the number one contender. And I guarantee you, that man can feel it. Triple H knows exactly. What Batista is capable of.
Look at Batista's neck and shoulders.
Flair again trying to lock up with the animal and to no avail.
That's a mind game. Whoa, so is that.
It's been an awesome night here tonight. On our road to WrestleMania, we heard earlier of the six-man Money in the Bank ladder match signed in the back of the eye by the Nature Boy. An eventful night, and that knife edge chop. Oh, and another hard chop. The trifecta, and Batista's barely flinching. Batista's taking Flair's best shots.
Oh, that's because Batista's fired up for this match.
Batista, the number one contender for the world heavyweight title. That man, a phenomenal athlete.
I think you could run into Batista with a freight train tonight. You wouldn't do any damage. Oh, this all against the 30-year veteran Ric Flair up in the light
in Hollywood to become the world's heavyweight champion. But I'll tell you this. Batista cannot beat the game on one leg. And the low blow with a referee distracted. Triple H just burned the referee's attention.
Well, that's why they call him the dirtiest player in the game.
And the cerebral assassin orchestrated that. And Flair took advantage. And now the finger pulled. Look at the unfair advantage that Triple H is providing Ric Flair. Batista rolled over quickly. The pressure down's on Flair. It's Flair's legs being punished.
How fast did Batista turn that figure four?
Flair trying to stand, obviously in pain. Flair's quickness will certainly be impaired in another shot. Great right hands. Oh, there again, and those chops, where they affect so many others, are not affecting Batista. Batista with that right hand, and Batista running that reverse elbow. Batista was starting to build some momentum, but Flair shut it down with that reverse elbow.
Come on, Nathan, you hit that. Oh, no. He's in trouble now. Oh,
Batista now. The animal with that blood pumping with an adrenaline rush. Oh, God. What impact. What a clothesline. And now Batista scooping up the Nature Boy. Modified power slam with a lateral press. And Batista came off Flair. And Batista maybe certainly didn't want to take his eye off Triple H, but I'm surprised Batista did not go for the cover there. Maybe there's more Batista wants to do.
Oh, yes.
And I think we know. Spine buster time.
Reminiscent of last week.
How ironic. Arn Anderson perfected it, and now Flair's feeling it. And now the thumbs up. And thumbs down as Batista looking eye to eye at the world's heavyweight champion. And Flair is a shell of himself that started this match.
And look at the gang.
The gang trying to come in the ring and out of the ring.
Just as fast as he came in.
Triple H trying to a cheap shot there. Batista too smart for it.
Batista bomb.
The Batista bomb. The set down power bomb. Batista hooking the near leg. And Batista beats Ric Flair.
Here is your winner, Batista.
The game came in from behind with that chop block. Triple H came in from behind, chopping that left knee again. And now what's the game doing here? Triple H looking for something and
what?
What the hell?
Another sledgehammer!
Triple H has got, he's loaded again for, he's got another sledgehammer.
Don't outsmart the game.
Batista down in a defenseless state here. And the game with that another sledgehammer. He was unarmed by the general manager, but the game has outsmarted the GM. He's outsmarted all of us.
Triple H may have his way here, and if he does, you can kiss that WrestleMania main event goodbye.
WrestleMania may be a memory to Batista. Batista blocks the game. The game was going for Batista's head with the sledgehammer. My God, look at the game's face.
Oh.
He's looking into his own destiny, into his own future.
Yes.
And Batista unarms the game.
Get up there, game.
And now the animal's got the sledgehammer.
Get out there and knock your head off.
Look at the game. He's begging. The game wants Batista to put the hammer down. Batista broke that sledgehammer right over his leg. And the game looks like he just saw a ghost. Maybe the game just saw his future.
You're gone.
Batista just told the game, you're gone. And everything Evolution throws at Batista to no avail. Batista King continues to build momentum toward WrestleMania.
He snapped that sledgehammer right in half like a toothpick.
And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the animal known as Batista, he came, he saw, he conquered, and thus far, nothing has slowed down Batista. Will he be the next World's Heavyweight Champion?